For the most important transactions in life, we oftentimes ask, can I see your ID? As these sensitive transactions are moved online, validating users' ID is critical. Join us today as we talk to Josh Wise about the DocuSign identification platform on this episode of Developer Deep Dive. Hi, my name is Matthew Rocknich, a developer evangelist at DocuSign. I'm here in the DocuSign studio with Josh Wise, who is a senior engineering manager responsible for auth and identity. Josh, it is great to have you on the show today.
Hi, Matt. Thanks for having me.
So, Josh, all this work on authentication and identity is incredibly exciting, internally. Can you tell us more about DocuSign Identify?
Sure. So, DocuSign Identify refers to our whole family of identity and auth products. Okay. It's basically a product family that encompasses all of our offerings to solve the business problem of automating identification. So it includes things like SMS or phone, round tripping of a code, knowledge-based authentication, ID check over a video camera for European qualified signatures, third-party custom-built solutions for customers' own custom needs, as well as our new ID verification product that we built ourselves.
Awesome.
Underneath all of that is what we call the DocuSign Identify platform, which is an open set of APIs and a protocol that allows customers to build their own custom identity solution as part of login to DocuSign envelopes. We built DocuSign ID verification on top of this platform as our first integration.
Great. So what really prompted, what was the inspiration behind this investment in identity solutions?
So customers in the past in non-US markets had a lot of trouble being able to adopt e-signature solutions due to different government regulations, like eIDAS, which is an EU-wide legal framework governing e-signatures. Okay. For example, in France, you have to use an electronic ID in order to, before you could apply an electronic signature to some documents. So with the Identify platform, developers in different parts of the world can legally integrate our agreement cloud, even if they have custom identity needs.
Excellent. So to that end, how can developers get started using this platform today?
So there's basically two solutions you could do. You could either, if you have a custom scenario that you need to build, you could build a custom identity or challenge for your signers to go through, or you could use the DocuSign built identity solutions like DocuSign ID verification through the eSignature API today. And we'll dig into the second one of those, the ID verification piece, because I don't know if we'll have time to show the whole protocol.
Great.
So when an envelope is sent with ID verification enabled, a recipient will receive an email notification from DocuSign, but before she can access the document, she'll be prompted to verify her identity by uploading a copy or taking a photo of her government-issued ID, so for this example, a driver's license. ID verification also supports passport and European eIDs. It analyzes ID features such as security markings, watermarks, to ensure validity. It also confirms the name on the ID matches the name on the agreement. Once her identity is verified, you're allowed to proceed and complete the remainder of the agreement process.
Perfect. So for which countries is this feature available?
So depends on the ID type. We support photo IDs and passports, electronic IDs and smart cards. So for driver's licenses and photo IDs, it's France, Canada, the UK, and the US. For electronic ID, it's Denmark, Finland, the Netherlands, Norway, Sweden, and Belgium. And for smart cards, it's Belgium, Brazil, Estonia, and Germany.
That is quite a few different combinations, which is awesome.
We're working on building out more also. So.
Perfect. So let's just focus in on just the photo IDs for today. So what exactly is being verified on those IDs?
So there are checks done to make sure the ID isn't expired and that the name that comes off the ID matches the name of who the person's supposed to be specified by the sender. There's checks to make sure that the MRZs, the barcode or machine-readable zone, like QR code looking thing, the information that matches the information on the front of the ID, that the visual features in the ID, like holograms, match what they're supposed to, so it doesn't look like a piece of paper, and that there's no evidence that the text has been tampered, so like the font matches across the front of the ID, it doesn't look like you changed it in Photoshop or something.
Got it. On the topic of tampering, I know the dev community is very sensitive, you know, to PII leaks. Do we store these IDs?
No. We toss them away at the end of the transaction. Okay. They're just in memory for processing.
Excellent. Any other default limitations of IDV for our dev community to know?
So ID verification is available in demo to build API integrations today. It's not enabled by default. It's only internal enablement today. So after creating a demo sandbox account, you'd have to contact a DocuSign account manager or a partner account manager to enable it. In the future, we'll have these solutions available for self-service. We don't have that available yet today.
Perfect. So assuming that our developer has talked to their account manager and turned on IDV in their demo account, Can you show us a demo of what would be a next step for them?
Yeah, so I have a couple Postman requests here. So ahead of this, I've obtained my OAuth token, I've logged in, and I'm using the DocuSign eSign Postman collection. So this request here is just a GET request to accounts, my account ID, and identity verification. This will show me, if I send this, all of the identity workflows that this account has access to send, to attach to its recipients in order to do identification in front of access to envelopes. Right. So this is our test account and demo, so it has a bunch, because we test a bunch of scenarios. The one that I care about here is DocuSign ID verification, which is our out-of-the-box ID verification solution that we talked about. These identity workflows are what represent those set of ID configurations as to that will be self-service in the future that will define what types of things you can have your recipients go through. So if I grab that ID and I come over here and I want to create an envelope, I'm going to post to my account /envelopes. This will look familiar to anyone who's sent envelopes through the eSign API before. So I'm going to send and create in the same call. I just have a PDF here, email, subject. I only have one recipient. It's a signer. That's me. So I'll be able to see the email. I have this workflow ID that I grabbed earlier that will cause me to go through ID verification. So if I send this request, I will see that an envelope was created and sent. So if I come over to my inbox, I should get an email. And if I follow the link in this email, you'll see the screen that we saw earlier. That you'll see that I'm prompted for ID verification before I could access this envelope.
Excellent, very cool. So as a next step for developers watching this video, where should they get started with IDV?
So there are some resources available on the DocuSign Developer Center specific to ID verification. And to get started, there's a link in the description.
Very cool. Well, Josh, thank you so much for being a part of the series and being on the show today. Thank you. And that's all the time we have. So join us next month when Lauren Dunn talks to Fred Wade about customizing e-signature functionality from within Salesforce using our Apex toolkit. If you liked that video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for the latest DocuSign developer content. If you want to see a specific topic in a future video, comment below. For everything else, visit the DocuSign Developer Center.